A very good evening and Om Shanti to all of the listeners. Welcome back to your own channel, Seek the Soul, the Truth Lies Within. Today we're going to talk about the 328th day of a Gauri blessing. And by the way, to all of you, a Merry Christmas too. Maybe you're enjoying your evening right now. And when you get this message, you'll be enjoying this Vardhan too. So let's understand what does Baba have to say in today's blessing. Baba says, may you belong to your own land. We souls, we don't belong to this world. We've just come to play our part. We actually belong to the supreme abode or the godfatherly home or the soul world or the Brahmalok or the Parlok, whatsoever you want to call it. So God is reminding us of that land before the end of this Kali Yuga. So may you belong to your own land and stay beyond by considering this old world to be foreign to you. Let's get into the explanation part. Baba says, some people do not touch anything from abroad, for they believe that they should only use things from their own land. So that was happening during the Gandhi period also. People were doing the boycott. They were leaving all the goods of the Western world and they were adopting to their own goods, homemade goods. And the same thing has happened over here also during the pandemic. People were like, let's boycott the Chinese goods and let's get into the homemade Indian products. So same thing, some people have these kind of favoritisms or they have this kind of thinking that I should only help my own country first and then maybe the other countries too. So God says the same thing over here. In the same way, this old world is foreign to you. So we are in Kali Yuga. God says Kali Yuga is full of vices, full of differences, full of all glitz and glamour all over the world, which is getting you into greed or ego or jealousy or competition or comparison, and it's keeping you away from me, from the truth also and from the true knowledge also. So Baba says this means that whatever it is of the old world, what are those things which are of the old world? Are nature in this old world. For example, it is natural to get angry when things are not getting done, or it's natural to be angry on people when they're not doing their work, or it is okay to be jealous, it's okay to be competitive or comparative, otherwise how will you progress in life? Well, spirituality says you can still progress in life without having all these negative emotions within you. So that is a nature. Then old world also comprises of sanskars, that means habits. We have habits of the old world, like everybody else is living. We are also living in the same manner, thinking for the self and for nobody else. If I am okay, my tummy is full, my pockets are full, I am perfect, I am in heaven, but I don't care about others. So that's an old sanskar. So God says, do not be even slightly attracted to them. These old world and the old sanskars or habits and the old nature. So then what do we do? Baba says, be one who has love for your own land, that is the supreme abode. That is, consider yourself to be a resident of the supreme abode. That means where Supreme Godfather lives, beyond the stars, beyond the moon, beyond the sun, in the supreme abode, the godfatherly abode, where we all souls have come from. And when we forget that we have come from there and we have nothing of this world, then we get into all vices, we get into jealousy, we get into greed, we get into ego, as if we want to live on this earth forever. And God is trying to remind us, become humble, become peaceful, become courageous in taking the right path. Be somebody who is selfless and help other souls. Be on my path, and you can only do that when you remember your original home where you come from. And when you forget that this is a foreign land and this is just a place where you come to spend some time on earth and do your karmas, you start to believe that this is what you deserve on this earth and this is where you belong to. And then all the negative karmas are done then. So then Baba says, be one who has love for your own land, that is, consider yourself to be a resident of the supreme abode in terms of the soul, and a resident of Madhuban, that is Mount Abu where we come from, the spiritual university, in terms of the divine family, That means when we look at the physical world, we should believe or we should get connected and feel at home when we are at Mount Abu, a spiritual family where all of us feel together. And then Baba says, in terms of the divine family, maintain this intoxication. And that will help us to be away from the old world, from the pain and suffering of the old world, to the attractions of Maya of the old world, and we'll be protected from everything which God wants us to be safe and protected from. And all the sufferings will then slowly, slowly become smaller and smaller in our life. So this is what God wants us to do. How do we do that? For that, you will have to visit the Brahma Kumaris Spiritual University and find out all the knowledge about the old world and how to get rid of the old habits and the old sanskars too. Have a blessed good night and a Merry Christmas to you again. Om Shanti.